Hi, I'm Terry Calls, and I'm going to demonstrate how to configure a monitor mix on an actual mixing board. I will be using a PreSonus StudioLive 24.4.2 digital mixing board. The 24.4.2 indicates that the mixer has 24 channel inputs plus 4 subgroup or submix buses and a 2 channel or stereo main channel output. But the part of the StudioLive that we will focus on today are the aux send or auxiliary buses and how they are used to provide individual monitor mixes for the performers during a live performance. An aux bus provides outputs or auxiliary mixes that are separate from the mains and the subgroup or submixes. The StudioLive has 10 analog aux send and 2 internal effect sends. While the 10 aux sends are mono, they are capable of being linked for stereo output. But for the purposes of this presentation, I will show you how our band uses them when we play a live gig. Each of the 10 aux sends can provide separate output levels for each of the 24 input channels, plus digital effects A and B via aux A and aux B, as well as a CD or iPod or DAW input, as well as the sound engineer's talkback mic. Each of the 10 aux sends have a solo, pre-post fader send, and output level control. In addition, each aux send has its own dynamic and filter controls, as well as output feeds from the mixers to delay processors. Now let's take a look at just one of the 10 aux buses. The solo button turns soloing on and off, which allows the sound engineer to listen only to that aux send's mix. When the post fader send button is enabled, the aux send bus will be affected by what happens on the faders. Never a good idea when you are setting the mix to a performer's monitors. The output level control knob adjusts the master output level to that specific aux send. So if a performer wants their monitor level to be louder or softer, that is adjusted using this knob. When the aux send select button is pressed once, it provides access to its various dynamics controls, such as a compressor, a gate, and a limiter expander, as well as the filter controls, including a high-pass filter and 4 fully parametric EQs. This is very important in order to eliminate feedback in the monitor. Pressing the mix button once accesses each of the 24 input channels. Turning the knobs on the various control knobs corresponding to each channel allows you to set the signal amount from each channel that is sent to that aux send. In addition, on the StudioLive, pressing the mix button a second time switches the first 6 meters to become the send controls for the DAW, a CD or an iPod, and the 2 onboard digital effects processors. In our band, we use 6 of the aux sends, 1 for each player. 5 of the aux sends are used to mix stage monitors, and 1 is used for a mono headphone mix for the drummer. Here is how we configure the monitor mix. First, we press the mix button once to access each of the 24 input channels. We then turn the various control knobs corresponding to each channel to set the signal amount from each channel that is sent to that aux send. We then press the mix button a second time, which then switches the first 6 meters. From there, we then use the 2 control knobs that correspond to the 2 onboard digital effects processors to set the amount of effects that are sent to that aux send. Second, we then press the aux send select button, which provides access to the compressor, gate, and limiter expander, as well as the high pass filter and fully parametric EQs. This is very important in order to eliminate feedback in the monitor. Now, to get your aux sends to the monitors or headphones, you need to connect the aux send outputs to the monitor headphone amps. You do that from the aux balanced or TRS outputs from the back of the mixer. Best practice is to then connect either a balanced line 1/4-inch cable or an XLR cable from the aux sends output to a balanced line input to the monitor or headphone amp, the output of which are then connected to the input of each monitor or headphone. So that is my presentation. I know it's a lot of material to pack into 5 minutes, but I hope you start to familiarize yourself with the terms and the overall concepts. Until later, ciao.